this first mound. Yeah, this is an otter. And according to Tales of Dakota Ray, was written by an English trader, fur trader in Pardesine, let Dakota Ray stay with him. He was 80 some years old. If he'd tell him the stories about the mountains and stuff, say in the wintertime. And this was built on a red otter, chief red otter. He was murdered by his own tribe, younger tribe members, but they liked him so much that they built a mound in the book near Muscadet and buried him in it. You can almost point to the point. He wasn't buried very deep. And the tip of his tail points to where the sun rises on the longest day of the year. This is where I got really interested in it, because about 70 yards, a little over 70 yards long. And now there's one there, one back there, yeah, that one, and there's one over there. Yeah, this is where the sun sets on the shortest day of the year. See, this is just like living next to I-94, you know, back then. That's where all the real transportation was, on the river, you know. The Red Otter's Mound. There's a mound there. That's in line with that one over there. There's three mounds here. Here, one, two, three, and the fourth one. They're right in line. Kind of a platform. And that's pretty flat back there. And this is where they talk to the troops when they're doing their ground-penetrating radar. With me, I didn't really get nervous, but they did seem to be nervous. They said it's too spooky, you know, in the daytime, you know. But I don't know. I remember walking through it in dusk sometimes. And and my back of my head would come up, you know. This is called a Serpent's Mound. Why it's called a Serpent Mound, it's a snake losing its skin. You see it splitting here. And also there's 24 bodies here, according to ground penetrating radar that we sourced out. Runs about 75 yards, something like that, down, right down here. And there's this one mound after, this shoulder to shoulder, there are bodies in here. You get a feeling up here. I'd always want to sit up here all day someday, but I get a little shaky too. See, there's a small end, and see the bigger mounds coming up there. And they say, think those are much older, the experts, than these. They were the Hopewell, they thought. They're conical, but see how much more, they're kind of peaked. These others are lower. These would be about the time of Christ. You know, there's somebody, I always feel this. We're getting a little coaching somewhere.
Getting a little what?
Coaching from somebody, something. I don't quite understand the spirit angle of it. It seems to work for some. They would preserve it if anybody would. I thought, which a lot of people in the government would like to have this divided, subdivided. But I thought one of my reasons for selling it, that Native Americans could protect it, you know, with their history and their development, what they want. And it makes me feel good that they do that. Well, this is, I think, is a very spiritual place. Well, it's got to be. You're going to lose this stuff. We just will lose that. We're going to lose everything, you know. You lose that. Kind of lose that where we're from, you know. The beginning. See, if you're going to keep a tribe or you could keep anything, you've got to have a history. And you got to love the land, you know. Makes you feel good. Something is like we owe it something, isn't it? It's something really old.